ادعوا إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه. Today we are going to start part 2 of الدرس الثالث عشر. Last lesson we covered part 1 or the homework for part 1. So we've completed part 1. Now we're going to go over part 2. And as we mentioned previously, that الدرس الثالث عشر focuses on the plural forms in the Arabic language. We mentioned that there are three plural forms. The sound plural, al-jam al-salim, which is divided into two, jam al-mudhakkar al-salim and jam al-mu'annath al-salim. Then we have the broken plural, which is jam al-taksir. So in total, there are three forms. In part 2, the author, he focuses on jam al-mu'annath al-salim. Jam al-mu'annath al-salim is where the singular form remains unchanged, but we add alif and ta. We add alif and ta to get to the plural form. And this is what we're going to notice in today's lesson, inshallah. So it's similar to the jam mudhakkar salim, where the singular form remains intact, it remains unchanged, but we add waw and noon or ya and noon for the jam mudhakkar salim. But jam mu'annath salim, we add alif and ta. We are adding alif and ta. Jam mudhakkar salim, we add waw and noon or ya and noon. Okay, let's read today's class. من هؤلاء الفتيات يا مريم؟ من هؤلاء الفتيات يا مريم؟ Who are these girls, O Maryam? فتيات is the plural of فتاتٌ. So we have فتن, right? We covered last lesson. فتن is young boy, young lad. The plural of فتن is فتياتٌ. فتياتٌ. The feminine version of فتن is فتاتٌ, young girl. The plural of فتاتٌ is فتياتٌ. فتياتٌ. So we mentioned that to get to the جمع مؤنث سالم, we take the مفرد and we add ألف and ta. If the word has ta marbuta, we have to remove the ta marbuta. So if we were to go by what we just mentioned, we would get, so fata, we take off ta marbuta, and then we add alif and ta, right? Alif and ta. Okay, this is what we are supposed to get going by the rules that we just mentioned. However, the rule that we just mentioned, that you add alif and ta, if there's ta marbuta, you remove it. These are basic rules. There's going to be some exceptions to some of the jam mu'annath salim words. There are going to be some rules which we learn down the line, inshallah, which we can't mention now because we are still in the basic or beginning stages. So words like fatatun becoming fatayatun, this is something which requires more explanation and requires more study. And another word that's going to come is bintun. Bintun, the plural form is banatun. Banatun. Also, what's going to come is ukhtun. The jam mu'annath form of this is akhawatun. Akhawatun. So with bintun, we have banatun. You see how the harakat have changed? With ukhtun, we have the addition of waw. We didn't say ukhtatun or bintatun or fatatun. We said fatayatun. The ya was added. Yeah? So these three are examples that the rules that we have mentioned are general. There's going to be some extra rules which govern other words. So words such as these, at this beginning stage, we just have to memorize. So fatatun, the plural of fatatun is fatayatun. The plural of bintun, daughter, is banatun. Ukhtun, sister, akhawatun. So examples such as these, we just have to memorize at this stage. once we continue studying, we learn the rules, inshallah, then we will know where the ya came from and the waw, where it came from, and so on. But most of the words that's going to come in this lesson, or most of the words that's covered, that are given in Jam Mu'annath Salim, they follow the rule that we mentioned. So if there's ta marbuta in the singular, you have to remove it. And then you add alif and ta, alif and ta to the end of it. This is something which is general, and we find in many examples that this is the case. But in some cases, there are some exceptions or exceptional rules or additional rules that are mentioned, which it's not befitting to mention at this stage. Okay, so we have, notice how ha'ula'i has been used in this lesson, and ha'ula'i was used in the previous lesson. So in the previous lesson, part 1, ha'ula'i al-fityatu, this was mainly mudhakkar. So he focused on the mudhakkar plural forms. So that's why he mentioned jam mudhakkar salim and jam taksir also, because jam taksir comes in both, it's applicable for both mu'annath words and mudhakkar words. It's used for both. Whereas jam mudhakkar salim is mainly for the masculine, and jam mu'annath salim is mainly for the feminine words. Okay, so ha'ula'i, ha'ula'i, this is mushara, is used for both masculines and feminines, so long as they are people. Yeah, it has to be for intellectual beings, males or females. You don't use it for objects or items. That's the whole point of him mentioning ha'ula'i here as well. ha'ula'i al-fatayatu ya Maryamu. Who are these young girls, or Maryam? Hunna zamilati. Hunna zamilati. They are my colleagues. Hunna is a new pronoun. Hunna is a new pronoun. This is the feminine version of hum. If you're talking about a group of males, you're talking about them, you say they, you say hum. If you're talking about a group of females, you say hunna, they. If you're talking about a mixture of males and females, you always use the mudhakkar pronouns. Even if there is just one man amongst a group of women. So if you had 100 women and one man, so 101 people, 100 of them were women and one man, we'd still use the mudhakkar pronouns, the masculine pronouns, to refer to them. So we'd say hum, they, kada wa kada. Okay, so hunna is the plural form of hiya, just as hum is the plural form for huwa. Huwa, he. Hum, they, masculine forms. Hiya, she. Hunna, plural for she, so they. My feminine version. Hunna zamilati. They are my colleagues. Zamilat is the jam mu'annath salim for zamilatun. So this is an example of where the rules that we just mentioned are applicable. So zamilatun. 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 To get to the jam mu'annath salim, we have to take off the ta marbuta. Then we add alif and ta. So we have zamilatun. Zamilatun. So he's saying my colleagues. So we add ya, which is ya al-mutakallim, to the end of it. And if this ya is added, the letter before it has to take kasra. So we took off the dhammatain, so it becomes zamilati. They are my colleagues. They are my colleagues. Hunna zamilati. They are my colleagues. A'akhawatun hunna. Akhawat is the plural of ukhtun. Ukhtun means sister. Akhawatun, sisters. A'akhawatun hunna. Are they sisters? A'akhawatun hunna. Are they sisters? Na'am. Hunna akhawatun. Yes, they are sisters. Man abuhunna. Man abuhunna. Who is their father? So the muttasil version of hunna looks exactly the same. So hunna is the detached version. and this is the attached version. They look exactly the same, just like hum. Hum, when it's detached, it looks the same as when it's attached. It's still hum. Hum remains the same. Man abuhunna, who is their father? So remember, whenever a dhamir is attached to a noun, it gives us mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. Abuhunna shaykhu bilalun. Abuhunna, their father, is the shaykh bilalun. Shaykh bilal. Abuhunna ash-shaykhu bilalun. Their father is shaykh bilal. Ummuhunna ustadhati. Ummuhunna ustadhati. Their mother is my teacher, is my ustadhatun. Ustadhatun, feminine of ustadh. Their mother is my teacher. Okay, abuhunna, this is mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So abu is our mubtada. And the sign of abu being marfu' is the waw. Why is that? Because abu is from the category of nouns known as al-asma'ul khamsa, the five nouns. Remember, these five nouns are special because when they're marfu', they have a waw to represent the fact that they are marfu'. They have a waw showing that they are marfu'. Okay, so we've learnt abu and akhu also. Those two are from the five nouns. Abu hunna, so this is marfu', and it's also mudaf, and hunna is mudaf ilayh. Okay, so this is a jumla ismiya. Abu is our mubtada. Mubtada wa huwa mudaf, hunna mudaf ilayh. Al-shaykh now is our khabar. Abu hunna al-shaykh. Their father is the shaykh. So what's the i'rab of Bilal? What's the i'rab of Bilal? The i'rab of Bilal, the analysis of Bilal, when we analyze it grammatically, we say Bilal is badal, substitute. Substitute for the Shaykh. Bilal and Shaykh are referring to the same thing. Bilal and Shaykh are referring to the same thing. So we can take off this and it means exactly the same. Abu Hunna Bilal, their father is Bilal. Who is Bilal? Bilal is the Shaykh. Bilal is the Shaykh. But what's intended, whenever there's badal and mubdal minhu, the one who's speaking actually intends the badal. The badal is the focus of the speaker. The badal is actually the focus of the sentence. So if you remove the mubdal minhu, if you remove the mubdal minhu, the sentence makes more sense actually. It makes more sense than if it was to remove the badal. Abu Hunna Shaykh, their father is the Shaykh. That makes less sense than if it was to say Abu Hunna Bilal, their father is Bilal. Shaykh is only mentioned in preparation for Bilal. It's mentioned as an introduction for Bilal. It's just there to prepare the listener for what's going to be mentioned after, and that is the badal. So whenever badal is mentioned in the sentence, then that's the focus. You should pay more attention to that than the mubdal minhu. Abu Hunna Shaykhu Bilalun. And as we mentioned, the badal follows the i'rab of the mubdal minhu. So if this is khabar and it's marfu', Bilal is also going to be marfu'. Abuhunna shaykhu bilalun. Their father is Shaykh Bilal. Ummuhunna ustadhati. Their mother is my teacher. Aina baytuhunna. Where is their house? Aina baytuhunna. Where is their house? Baytuhunna qareebun min al-madrasati. Baytuhunna qareebun min al-madrasati. Their house is close to the madrasa, to the school. Their house is close to the school. If we was to analyze this, we'd say baytu mubtada wa huwa mudaf, hunna is mudaf ilayhi, qareebun is the khabar. Their house is close. The sentence ends here. Min al madrasati now is just extra. It's extra information. Harf jar is majur. So we say jarun wa majur. So this is the passage for today's lesson. Now we are going to set the homework. Tamareen, exercises. First exercise, حول المبتدا في الجمل الآتية إلى جمع كما هو موضح في المثال. Similar to the previous lesson that we did, same exercise. Change the مبتدا in the following sentences into the plural form as is illustrated in the example. Example here says, هذه بنت. So the mubtada is here, the khabar is bintun. The plural of hadhihi is ha'ulai. So if you're going to change the mubtada, it's also going to affect the khabar. Because mubtada and the khabar, if the khabar is one-worded, always match in gender and number. So you have to change both so that they are matching in gender and number. So this is jam' plural, this is plural. This is mu'annath, yani it's unisex. So it can be used for masculine and feminine. And this is feminine. هذه بنتٌ, this is a girl. هؤلاء بناتٌ, these are girls. The plural forms are given in the brackets. The plural forms are given in the brackets. So this is the first exercise. The second exercise is a reading and writing exercise. A reading and writing exercise. That's exercise number two. Then exercise number three here says, اقرأ المثال ثم حول الجمل الآتية مثله. Read the example, then change the following sentences مثله, similar to it. So the sentence here, the example says, زينب خرجت من الفصل. Zainab left from the class. Zainab left from the class. Now we have Zainab wa Amina wa Maryam. So we have three people. When you're talking about three people, it becomes they. How do we represent they left if it's feminine? If it was masculine, we add a waw to the end of the verb, right? Kharaju, Muhammad wa Ahmad wa Ali, kharaju. But if it's feminine version, they, it's a noon. Noon that comes. Noon with a fatha that comes. And when you add this noon to the end of the verb, you have to make sure that the end of the verb takes a sukoon. The verb must end with a sukoon before you add this noon to the verb. So if we had, for example, jalasa. Jalasa means he sat. Jalasa means he sat. If you want to say they sat, a group of males sat, before adding the waw, the last letter takes a dhamma. Before adding the waw, the last letter takes a dhamma. So it becomes jalasu, jalasu. Remember, after wawul jama'ah, this waw, there's always an alif that's written, but not read. So that means they sat. If it's a group of women, jalasa, then before adding the noon, this noon is called noon al-inath. Noon al-inathi. Noon al-inathi. Noon al-inathi. The noon of femininity. Or in some books, they call it noon. Noon al-niswa. Noon al-niswati. Noon al-niswati. Two names for the same noon. This noon represents a group of women have done such and such. This is the third person feminine plural. So this is third person masculine plural. So before adding the noon, the last letter of the verb takes a sukoon. So here it becomes jalasna, jalasna. And the same thing that we just mentioned here is applicable to all past tense verbs. So if it was kharaja, it would be kharajna. Jalasa, jalasna. Dhahaba, dhahabna. Okay. So that's what this exercise is telling us. Zainab, if you're talking about Zainab, is kharajat. She left. Kharajat, that ta, is showing that the fa'il is feminine. Showing that the fa'il is feminine is here. Here is hidden in this case. You look for it in the sentence. If it's not there, then it's going to be here, which is hidden. The dhamir is here and it's hidden. In this case, the dhamir is the noon. It's not hidden. That noon is what represents hunna. The noon here represents hunna. So Zainab wa Aminatu wa Maryamu, all of them mamnu' min al-sarf, kharajna, they left min al-fasli. Zainab wa Aminatu wa Maryamu, kharajna min al-fasli. They left from the class. And this sentence is a jumla ismiya. It's a jumla ismiya because it starts with a noun. So Zainab is our mubtada. And the khabar is coming as a jumla fi'liya, which starts from kharajat min al-fasli. So this jumla fi'liya is our khabar. And here, likewise, Zainab is our mubtada. Waw harf atf. Amina ma'tuf. Waw harf atf. Maryam ma'tuf to Zainab. So these are just ma'tuf, ma'tuf. But the actual mubtada is Zainab. Zainab is a mubtada. And where is the khabar? Khabar is kharajna min al-fasli. This jumla fi'liya. This is a jumla fi'liya. It's a verbal sentence. So verbal sentence coming as khabar and verbal sentence coming as khabar. Whenever there's a sentence coming as khabar, whether it's jumla ismiya or jumla fi'liya, there's always a link that's going back to the mubtada. So look here, the link is here, which is hidden here. Here, going back to Zainab. And here is kharajna, going back to Zainab and what it's ma'tuf to. What it's ma'tuf to. So we're talking about a group of them. Zainab wa Aminatu wa Maryam, all of them left. Min al-fasli, kharajna min al-fasli. So the same thing here. Al-mudarrisatu ذهبت, should be ذهبت with a sukun on the ta. المدرسة ذهبت إلى الفصل, the teacher went to the class. الطالبة الجديدة جلست في الفصل, the new student sat. بنت محمد ذهبت إلى المدرسة. So you need to use the plural form. So the مدرسة, you're going to say مدرسات, المدرسات. طالبة, you're going to use the plural form. Bintu, you're going to use the plural form. And once you use the plural form, you're not going to say ذهبت no more. You're going to say ذهبنا, جلسنا, ذهبنا. طيب, I hope that is understood. Next piece of homework, it says أشر إلى الأسماء التالية باسم إشارة للقريب. Point to the following nouns using an ism ishara, a demonstrative pronoun that's used for things which are close, pointing out things which are close. And you have an option of three ismul ishara: hatha, hathihi, ha'ulai. The difference between hatha, hathihi, ha'ulai is that hatha is for a singular masculine object, hathihi singular feminine object, whether they are intellectual beings or non-intellectual beings. So long as this one is masculine, you say hatha, and it's feminine, you use hathi. Whereas ha'ulai is for masculine and feminine. So long as they are intellectual beings, they have to be intellectual beings. So this is what you have to do. Use hatha or hathihi or ha'ulai to complete the sentence. Look at the object or the person being pointed at and choose the correct ismul ishara. The next exercise, ضعف الأماكن الخالية, place in the empty space, the empty spaces, من الجمل الآتية, in the following sentences, ضميرا مناسبا, a suitable pronoun. And you have a choice of four. هو, هي, هم, هن. هو means he, هي means she, هم, they, masculine, هن, they, feminine. So you need to complete the sentences using one of these four dhamirs. Then the next one, هاتي جمع الأسماء الآتية, give the plural forms of the following words. Give the plural forms of the following words. So these plural forms, I've already been mentioning in the brackets here. So when you cover this exercise here, by the end of this exercise, you should have memorized the plural forms that are given here. You should have memorized the plural forms that are given here before doing this exercise, inshallah. And then finally, it says al-asma' al-ishara al-qareeb. So here he's summarizing. These are the demonstrative pronouns that we have learnt for pointing out things which are close. So we have هذا طالبٌ. This is a student, masculine. هذه طالبةٌ. This is a student, feminine. So if it's masculine, هذا. If it's feminine, هذه. هؤلاء can be used for masculine and feminine. Plurals. هؤلاء طلاب, هؤلاء طالبات. The main focus with using هؤلاء is that you're using it for intellectual beings. So you're not considering the gender, you're considering they're being intellectual or not. If they're intellectual, you can use هؤلاء. If they're not intellectual beings, like animals or objects, then you cannot use هؤلاء. Whereas with هذا, هذه, we don't take into consideration whether they are intellectual beings or not. We have to focus on their gender, mainly. Gender. If it's مذكر, هذا. If it's feminine, هذه. So you can say, هذا كلب, هذه كلبة. Also, a feminine dog and a masculine dog. Animals. Or you can say, هذا بيت, objects. This is a house. هذه سيارة. This is a car. So objects, animals, and humans. So the main focus is on their gender only. الكلمات الجديدة, the new words. الزوج is spouse or partner. The plural is أزواج. أزواج is the plural of زوج, partners, spouses. المرأة is a woman. woman. The plural of al-mar'a is nisa'un, nisa'un, women. So the word al-mar'atu doesn't have a plural form which is taken from it. Instead, we have a different word that's coming to represent the plural form for mar'a. So look, there's no meme in this word, there's no ra in this word. So this is a completely new word that's come to show the plural form of al-mar'a. So mar'atu nisa'un. The plural of mar'a is nisa. We don't change it. We don't say maratun or miratun and so on. Al-mar'atu bidun al. Okay. So he's saying here in brackets, al-mar'atu without alif lam. Bidun means without. Al, without the alif lam, is imra'atun. So the word starts with a hamzatul wasl. The word starts with hamzatul wasl. Imra'atun, a woman. Al-mar'atu, the woman. Imra'atun. So the word is imra'atun, a woman. If it has alif lam, we say al-mar'atu. The hamzatul wasl is taken off. When we add al, the hamzatul wasl is taken off. And we say al-mar'atu. So imra'atun, we could say this is the third noun that we have learnt that starts with hamzatul wasl. We learnt ibn, we learnt ism, now we learn imra'a. Imra'a is the third noun that we've learnt in this book so far that starts with hamzatul wasl. Imra'atun. Qareebun means close. So this is today's lesson. Next lesson we're going to cover these pieces of homework, inshallah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.